G'day everyone, my name is David Marr. Welcome back to First Time Reefer TV. And today we're in Reefstock, Sydney 2018 for the first ever international Reefstock to be outside of Denver, Colorado. As you can see, the turnouts have been absolutely incredible. A bunch of magnificent vendors here, some incredible corals, and some really, really interesting products. So the first one I've seen here today is one of my all-time favorite products that I run on my tank myself. This is the Pax Bellum. Tristan, how are you, man?
Good to see you.
So Tristan is the creator
of
Pax Bellum. Manufacturer, creator. Are you still are you processing in a factory?
We're making everything in Vermont, in the US.
Fantastic.
Yeah,
that's crazy. So I know all the benefits of using your product, but if you could run through quickly, like, about your algal reactor.
I mean, I can take you through the device itself. So we have a bottom-up flow through the center. Impinges on the bottom plate, forces all the water through the mass of algae so you get maximum nutrient contact, and then out the top back into your system. There's some special features. The lighting assembly is cooled by a heat pipe, so behind the LEDs it's a hollow tube, and inside there's a vacuum with a small amount of water.
Yep.
So it boils at a lower temperature, and that takes the heat away from the backside of the LEDs up to the heat sink and dissipates it into the air. It prolongs the life of your LEDs.
Crazy.
And if you're...
Because I think a lot of people thought that the heat sink was to actually get rid of the heat out of your water. That's not what it is.
No,
it's about prolonging the life of the LED. Right?
Yeah.
Are these strips sort of just to hold it in place? Or?
Yep, you can put the algae in between the coils to keep it spread out along the axis.
Oh, I see.
Or you can turn the diffuser disc to grab the algae.
So this is a small puppy of the fleet, right?
Yeah, this is our smallest, the N18.
We got to this. This one here looks about 1.2, 4 foot tall?
About 3 feet tall, about 3/4 of a meter tall.
Okay.
Yeah. And this would be for a 1,000.
2 foot tank or?
what is it? Yeah, minimum would be 1,000 liter to 4,000 liter system.
Yeah. And obviously all the quality of the build, all the internals, the lights are still all the same, just in a bigger format.
Yeah.
But I notice that's a different heat sink.
Yeah, this is an extruded heat sink. We went through thermal analysis for this one, and that keeps the LEDs nice and cool. You can grab that.
Oh, crazy.
Yeah. And we have two series. We have the N series, which the N24, N18, all cast acrylic construction. And then we have the larger C series, the C30, C36, and that's PVC construction, stainless steel, 316L stainless steel hardware, stainless steel inserts, quad O-ring gaskets. So,
fantastic.
Overbuilt.
Yeah. Nothing wrong with being overbuilt. Nitrogen molybdenum?
Yep, nitrogen molybdenum.
Molybdenum?
It's one of my favorite words.
It's fun to say.
Yeah. And then we got the iron manganese.
Yep.
So this is just dosed to make sure that iron and manganese is present. And then the nitrogen molybdenum is dosed as needed. So you want to keep that ratio of nitrogen to phosphate 100:1.
Yep.
So if the nitrogen was depleted, the algae can no longer take up phosphate. So by dosing this, the algae can take up more phosphate.
Okay.
You can feed your system more. And,
so when you talk about actually dosing your tank with nitrates, because it's doing too well, essentially, you'd be dosing that. But you could you also adjust how much nitrate it consumes by adjusting the lighting period? Or is it always suggested to run it for X amount of period?
Well, we recommend starting off with 4 hours.
Yep.
So if you get some algae that's used to dim lighting, you don't burn it right away.
Yeah.
Start off with 4 and work your way up about an hour a week.
Yeah, okay. Yeah,
but you can definitely control your nutrient export by either ramping up the daylight hours or ramping it down.
Yeah, okay. Well, I know I ran mine on 4 hours for just on 4 weeks,
and that was completely jam-packed, caked full as soon as I opened it.
Yeah, so we've seen this one fill up in as little as 5 days.
Just
from a little ball of cheddar.
A huge fan of your product. Thank you for taking the time to speak to me.
All right, thank you.
You guys want to hit up their stand if you're at Reefstock. If not, visit their website, which is...
We're on Facebook.
Facebook?
Yeah.
So just Pax Bellum on Facebook?
Yeah.
Awesome. Hit them up. Check out their products. It's in really, really good stuff. Thank you.
Thanks.
Alrighty, guys, didn't make it very far past the Pax Bellum stand, but now we're over here at my second favorite store at the stand. I've spent all weekend hugging, feeling, touching, caressing their sumps because they're incredibly sexy units. Both Eric from Hmahli, the creator of all these sumps, he assembles them all himself. How you doing, man?
Good, bro.
Good, good. Tell us a little bit about your product, dude.
Okay, basically, mate, we're a family business. Started about 12 months ago, been in the hobby all of our lives. Found a niche in the market. No one here really doing acrylic stuff.
Did you say 12 months ago?
About 12 months
ago. That's crazy, man. And you're assembling stuff like this already. That's hectic.
We've sort of moved forward really quickly. So basically, at the moment, we're doing all custom stuff. We're looking at doing a standard range in the near future when we start putting our products into the stores.
But so you guys are more like a specialist?
At the moment,
Definitely. I mean, it's obviously quite a premium product. It's not something that Joe Blow's probably going to chat on his little nano tank. They are very, very intricate pieces of work.
Yeah.
They look really beautiful. But I think you're going to suffice for that sort of custom market that needs something built essentially for their tank.
Exactly.
Right? I mean, I think I noticed you did a tank for, is it 20? Like a tiny.
Yeah, so this is a little Pico one.
That's cool.
So it's a bit of a novelty thing, but it's obviously very functional and pretty much doing exactly what that thing there does, just on a smaller scale. Yeah, so from something that small, obviously, to, you know, your full hamburger with the lot.
So what made you decide to start this,
man? Mate, I couldn't answer that.
Crazy idea.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Obviously, you know, being in the game, built my own stuff for my own tank because I couldn't justify spending that sort of money on an import system. And then, just friends got on board and this is where we are today. So,
like, I legitimately mean, like, the work feels incredible. I don't even know how to describe it, man. Like,
I know,
when I came to meet you yesterday and actually saw the sump and I actually stood there just caressing the sump, like, it's just, I don't think it's just something you can't really describe, right?
And
the name Hmahli, what does the name Hmahli mean to you?
That's our daughter's name. One of our two twins, the youngest one, she was lucky enough to get the name. So that name is obviously our brand, and we stand by it. So
amazing, yeah. That's so beautiful. So you've obviously got the custom made sumps here that obviously light up like discos as well. You've done your own Beckett skimmers, your own mini reactors.
Yep.
You've got your Hyperflow mini reactors as well. Is that right?
Yep. So they're a standalone. They're a standalone upflow. We can make these in all different sizes. We can, you know, modify baffles to suit different types of medias, all that sort of stuff. So it's really endless with what we can do.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
I'm sure you can see someone's name in there. Really,
mate, we can customize for anybody. If someone wants to have a themed system, we can, by all means, you know, cater for that.
I'm just going to go through your stand.
Yeah, go for it.
Got little dosing containers.
Yep.
They come equipped already with the John Guest feeding.
Yep, so that's already ready, plug and play, ready to go. Again, we can make these in different sizes.
But you got them right up, so can I grab this?
Yeah, so you can grab the whole unit or just pull one out.
Whatever's on. I'll pull one out. So you got, how many litres is that?
So that's a 5.6 litre. Same principle, just obviously on a larger scale.
That's crazy.
So,
and I'm assuming a lot more products to come out there.
Oh, most definitely. Time's just our issue at the moment with, you know, being hit hard with so many orders.
Yeah.
So we're still obviously developing, bringing out new products. Maybe going to take a little bit longer than we expected, but obviously we'll get there in the end. So
one man show.
That's right. That's
you were
right.
Telling me, like, all these edges are hand polished.
All hand polished.
Hand polished. So you sit there polishing in my hand. Other guy, I think I've seen other guys, they don't finish on the edges, but I suppose that one makes it so nice to come. I know you're going to wipe this again, but is going to constantly keep feeling.
I think that's just the point of difference. It's just, yeah, the attention to detail that we put into it. At the end of the day, it's a premium product, and obviously, you know, it's got to go all the way. So
10 millimeter lids.
Yeah, all 10 millimeter
lids. Dosing fittings. Yep. What are those fittings down the end there?
These are all basically for our external reactors.
That's
our external reactors.
Just plumb them,
yeah, plumb them in. So this is a custom build for a client.
Yep.
So obviously we've set this up so as your system grows, it's all ready, so we can just keep adding to it. It doesn't have to change anything.
So, well done. I know you told me you had not a lot of previous experience working in acrylic.
Yeah.
You decided one day to create some products, and man, you've just gone balls deep and gone for it. So huge respect to that.
Thanks.
I wish you all the best. I know I messaged you early on saying that you guys are going to smash it. I can see your likes go from like 200 and something to about 6,000 today.
Yeah, we're up there.
Which is crazy, right?
So a lot of international people in our own backyard following this, so it's been phenomenal. It's
fantastic.
Great support, so.
Fantastic. I love the shouting innovators there. But thank you so much, dude. Thanks for the chat.
Thank you very much. Thanks. Thank you.
Alrighty, so we're over here at the Salty Pets stand. My absolute favorite. Oh my god, Coral, right? They do insane LPS. And the Scotties that you'll absolutely fall in love with, Softies at a next level, and they do it on a really tight ship. So we've got Bruce here. I don't even know how to say your surname, man. Like, how do you say that?
As many letters as we have, that's how many different names
we have.
It's
like the whole alphabet in there.
Almost the whole alphabet. It's pronounced Bezuidenhout.
Bezuidenhout. Bezuidenhout. Oh, that sounds so poetic. Now tell us a little bit about Salty Pets, man.
Okay, look, Salty Pets was formed about 15 years ago.
Yep.
We're a family business. We started off just doing aquarium fish, and then we got into corals.
Yeah.
And corals are a lot easier.
So are you still doing fish, or now you've just primarily just moved to corals?
We basically do fish to order. We don't want to hold fish too long. We prefer they just swim around out in the ocean, and if someone needs something, we will go and
grab it.
Yeah,
go for the order. That's crazy. So it's just you, Heath, mum and pop?
Mum and dad.
So on and above the four of us in the warehouse here, David, we have a dive team of just three guys that head out and spend the time underwater, doing the hard yards, trying to pick out the choice pieces, and all of these corals that you guys have seen here at Reefstock. So we'd like to give them a big shout out to our dive team. Without you guys, we wouldn't have all of these great pieces to show off.
Yeah, totally, because I think he can't collect anymore.
He had an embolism, yep. An aeroembolism. So he comes out and snorkels with us.
Yep.
But in terms of scuba diving or on the hooker system, this is myself, my dad, and a couple of other divers. So.
Crazy, because I'm going to say, in regards to like next level coral, you guys are probably the specialists in that. You guys constantly come up with like the most amazing pieces I've ever seen in the hobby, which is great. Fused colonies of Aiken.
Yes.
There's a fused tri-color colony over there.
Yes.
Like, it must be just where you're collecting, or you guys are searching deeper, or you're going out further. What is it different that you guys are doing?
So we collect in a similar area to some of the other collectors in the East Coast. I guess what we're doing differently, we're not rushing our trips. I'm not saying that anyone else does, but our trips are anywhere between 4 and 6 days.
Yeah,
so really hunting. We swim around a lot underwater. We're trying to find the right piece instead of just getting in, trying to get as much as you can before your bottom time's up. We're not into that. You basically go, all right, we're going to go down, look for those couple of nice pieces. If you come up with five pieces, that's what it is. We don't try and fill our baskets just to get to the top.
Yeah.
We swim around a lot underwater.
Amazing.
We cover some miles.
Yeah. And I know your tanks are relatively empty now, but at the start of the show, these three frag tanks were stacked to the Shison house, right?
Yes.
Like,
absolutely.
You guys have the biggest store here, the most amount of frags, and you've nearly cleaned them all out.
Yes.
I know when I got in early yesterday morning, took a few shots.
Yes.
5-10 minutes after the doors open, I reckon you saw 20 of your scullies that you had on there.
Hammered, yeah. And a couple of other stores are existing customers, like Billy from Aquaristic, Reptile, those guys, they came and picked a few choice items.
Yeah.
And after that, we got hammered. So.
Amazing, man.
And that's a one-time thing as well. As we are wholesalers, we don't generally sell to the public.
Yeah.
But it's just a show special. That's what we want for the guys.
That's really showing people what you can
collect. Showing people what you can collect, and refuse the other stores as well, and it's a chance to come and pick the eyes out of some really choice pieces that they might not see on our stock list.
Amazing. And I noticed you kidnapped an American dude at the back.
Jason Fox.
How does that even happen?
Look, Jason and I, we had a long relationship.
Did he purchase it?
Yes.
From you?
Yeah. Amazing. So if you guys follow Jason Fox, you'll see some of
Sure, like everyone knows the name Jason Fox.
Yes.
Right.
So he's come out, he's been collecting with us. When this show's finished, next week we'll probably go around collecting.
Yep.
So hopefully we'll get some choice items, maybe even a new coral to be named as a signature coral for Jason.
Amazing. So, please share photos on your Facebook
page. Will be,
which is Salty Pets PTYLTD.
Yes, correct. Yeah, we also have Instagram.
Yep.
Salty.
Which, salty dot pets.
Yes. Dot Australia.
Dot Australia. Yeah. Any website?
No. We do have a website, but as I said, there's just four of us doing it. I do all the social media. I really don't have time to run the website, so it's purely Instagram and Facebook. It's so quick and easy.
Welcome to 2018.
Yeah, exactly.
So if you guys don't follow their social media accounts, please do, because if you want to see what the epitome of a really unique or sexy coral is, these guys are the ones that'll do it for you. I've seen pictures of your facility. I'm going to try and visit your facility
later
this year. I'd love to go
and
shoot.
If any members of the public see a coral on our Facebook or Instagram, although we can't sell to you direct,
tag your local fish store
and get them to say, hey, I've seen this, and we'll organize to send the coral down to your fish shop and you can grab it from there.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for your time.
Excellent.
I know you're busy,
but
enough talking. Mic drop montage of all their corals. Hope you enjoyed part one of the Reefstock series, and there are many more fun-filled adventures to come. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll leave it to these guys to say goodbye.
Yep.
1, 2, 3.
Peace.
1, 2, 3.
Peace.
1, 2, 3.
Peace.
1, 2, 3.
Peace.